In this video, we're integrating e to the sine x cosine x dx, first by informally using the chain rule, and then second by using a formal u substitution. And that formal u substitution, usually what it's about is just recognizing the results of the chain rule and using it backwards. So informally, the key here is to recognize a function of a function. That's e to the sine x, where the inner function is sine x, and that happens to be sitting right next to the derivative of that inner function. I recognize this as a result of the chain rule. This exponential happens to be the special function that's equal to its own derivative. So I'm asking, where did this integrand come from? What do I differentiate to get this integrand? And it's just e to the sine x. If I differentiate that, I would have to use the chain rule, and it would produce e to the sine x times the derivative of sine x with respect to x, which is that cosine x piece sitting right next to it. It doesn't hurt to check your work. Actually, this is really good for improving your intuition about the chain rule. So I have a function of a function, e to the sine x. I differentiate that with respect to the inner function. So with respect to sine x, treating sine x like a single variable. And the derivative of e to something is just e to that thing. The chain rule then says you have to tack on the derivative of that inner function with respect to x, which is cosine x. And I've verified that I have the right antiderivative. When you're using a formal u substitution, you still have to recognize what the inner function is. So I still have to see that sine x is the inner function here, and that I have the derivative of that hanging around right next to it. So I'm going to say let u be that inner function, sine x. Now I need the differential of u, so I take the derivative of sine x times dx, so that's cosine x dx. And now when I look at my original integral, I see u up here, and I see du right next to it. So my integral has been transformed into e to the u du. The antiderivative of e to the u is just e to the u. I then replace u with its definition in terms of x, and we're done. If you find the math content on Zach's Lab helpful, click on the Zach's Lab logo on the right to browse playlists and subscribe to the channel. I produce dozens of new videos per month, and subscribing is the easiest way to find new content. Thanks for watching.